Hi everyone, I'm Trucker Ray. Welcome to my YouTube channel if this is the very first time you're visiting. I share my experiences out here on the highways of Canada, and I love to share what it's like to have a Savior, the Gospel of Jesus Christ, as I like to call him, Yeshua, his original Hebrew name, Yeshua, however way you want to say it. And been doing this now for almost going on 5 years, or has it been 5 years or 4.5 years, something like that. I just wanted to let you guys know, and please bear with me, I've got a little bit of a cold. First one I've had in a very long time, but I have a little bit of spray stuff I got from Sage that hopefully I can kill the bacteria, and then I'm going to munch down on a couple oranges and overdose on some vitamin C. Hopefully that'll help. I'm at the yard right now in New Westminster, and I did have a load that I was supposed to be taking out this morning, but for some reason the planner gave me a load that didn't exist, so by the time I got here it was late last night, and I couldn't call anybody because nobody could help me, whoever was answering the phones. So I gotta wait it out for another hour or two before the dispatcher comes in. I got a feeling I'm gonna be sitting here for a while today, but that's okay because apparently it's really snowing. I checked the weather forecast, 20 centimeters, 20 to 25 centimeters expected for the canyon, the Coquihalla. It's gonna be ugly out there today, and it's supposed to turn to rain in the canyon by noon. So if I leave here by 10 o'clock or 11, I won't care because it'll be turning to rain. So it's been really, really ugly. I drove on Christmas Day. It was really, really beautiful. There wasn't a person on the road, which was really nice. And Boxing Day on the way back. Little different story. A lot of people on the road, and it was snowing pretty well from Revelstoke all the way to Kamloops. And when I got into Kamloops, I didn't have the camera rolling. The four-laner was just a sheet of ice, and there were people in the ditch everywhere. I'm thinking, figures I'm not having the camera rolling today. But, you know, there wasn't anything too terrible that I had to, or dramatic, that I needed the camera. I've decided to take this week off, and that's why I'm giving you this update from the camera. And I want to use this opportunity. We get into involved with the holiday spirit and the holiday time and family and friends, and we got a lot of things on our mind and things that we want to get people. And it doesn't take much to put the Lord on the back shelf. And it doesn't take much to take our focus off of Him. Yeah, we went to Sunday service, we went to Christmas Eve service, all that stuff. But you kind of feel something lacking in your spirit, in your heart. And you're like, Lord, I've really been neglecting you because I've had so much on my mind. And we have to learn to include Him in everything and still, you know, get on a regular routine of reading our Bible in the morning and get on a regular routine of taking my walks and saying my prayers. And I still love to do all that stuff, but the last couple of weeks has been really, really lacking. So I decided to take this week off, no cameras, nothing, and just refocus, get my attention back on the Lord, get back into my routine, and prepare myself for 2017. Now, folks, my dear YouTubers, I'm not a psychic, I'm not a prophet, but if something, I want to use this little clip and keep this just in the event I'm right. And if I'm right, then I'm going to know that the Spirit has been talking to me, the Holy Spirit. I have a feeling in my heart, something amazing is going to happen in my life. Not during the winter, but in the spring and early summer. Something. And I don't know what it is. Maybe the Lord will reveal a calling in my life. Maybe something else will happen. I don't know. But I really feel like He's put on my heart that I'm supposed to use this time during the winter to get over past hurts and heal whatever hurts that are going on inside of me. And there's a few I'm still getting over. And focus my attention on Him. And new and beautiful things will, healing will take place over the winter, and new and beautiful things will happen in the spring. That's what I feel that's been put on my heart. So if something amazing happens, we've got this as a testimony to prove that. So wouldn't that be amazing? And if, you know what, if nothing does really happen, oh well, something to look forward to, even though if it doesn't, right? We'll see what happens. So, but I wanted to also say that I really, really appreciate everyone that's been leaving comments on my videos and all the subscribers. Just yesterday alone, I had like 20 subscribers just yesterday. I don't know how many of those will stick around. I hope they do stick around. But obviously, and I've had a lot of comments about the videos and that they are very inspiring to people and that they enjoy them and they're very professionally done. And I thank you for those compliments. That really, really makes me feel good that you guys are enjoying it, because it takes a lot of work to make those videos. It's, you don't just slap it together. There's music chosen, the transitions have to match the music and everything. There's a lot of work involved. I don't know if you guys have ever watched, if you listen to a song on my videos as it transitions into a, you know, a drum beat or a guitar solo or a piano solo or something, the scene changes. And I do that deliberately. I match the music to the scenes, or should I say, I match the scenes to the transitions in the music. Watch that next time and you'll see what I'm talking about. And just that alone takes extra time. But I love doing the videos because it's awe-inspiring. When people see the scenery, they think of God. And that's the whole point of these videos, is to give God as much glory as I can. And so people will say, praise God, look how beautiful that is. Or praise God when they hear a song and it mixes with music, where they see wildlife on the side of the road. So it's pretty exciting. One other announcement I want to make. Springtime. I am going to be taking some classes on learning the macros to get over the border. And I am going to start doing a triangle run in the spring in the U.S., which goes down to California, I believe over to Nevada, Idaho, right across, almost up to, on this side of Mississippi, and up through a few other states, and up through Toronto, and across Canada. That round trip usually takes about 10 to 12 days. And I'm going to be doing one of those a month. So I'll be spending half my time in the US and half my time here. And the reason why I'm doing that, two reasons, is this year or next year, the summer is going to be horrific when it comes to traffic, because they're going to be starting more construction on the Highway 1 because they're trying to four-lane it the whole way to Calgary, or to the whole way to Lake Louise, rather, from Kamloops to Lake Louise. And that's just, plus all the campers and everything, it's going to be a nightmare. It's not going to be enjoyable. So I thought, you know what, this is the year to start driving in the US. So I can spend half my time out there in the US, half my time up here. And second of all, you guys will get to see some brand new stuff, new adventures. It'll be a brand new adventure for me. It'll be an exciting new adventure for me. And I'm sure for you guys too, as you get to share with me, you know, the good, the bad, and the ugly about these new places I'll be driving. And maybe I'll meet some new people down there, some people I'm interacting with on YouTube that are also other truck drivers down there. That would be really cool. So that's the plan. Springtime, new horizons. Be going stateside halfway, it's about 10 or 11 days out of the month. So I hope you guys are looking forward to that, because I'm going to do that. Yeah, so anyway, that's all I have for you. I just wanted to let you know, if you don't see a video up for the next, I mean, because I would be recording this week and then I would take end of the week to put up a video. So normally you would get a video, say, what is today, Wednesday or Tuesday, I don't even know what day it is today, and then you would see a video, say, 6 or 7 days from now up, and then it takes me another 4 or 5 days to do more recording. So we're looking at a couple weeks before, so expect a new video probably in the at the first week, at the end of the first week, maybe the 7th or the 6th or the 7th or something of 2017. I'm looking forward to putting something together for you, and I hope you guys stick around for that. So in the meantime, if you're brand new to the channel and you're like, oh, that sucks, I just got here and I don't get to see some videos, there's a lot of archive videos on my channel. Go check them out. I think you'll enjoy them. So for now, I hope you guys had a great holiday. Hope you kept your eyes fixed on Him, and maybe join me on this. Join me on this during this next week. Fix your eyes back on the Lord. Get into your Bible studies. Take your walks. you know, yeah, the holidays are up, it's over, it's done. Now, let's get back into the Word. Let's get back into spending time with Him. Let's get back into our prayer. Let's get back in our regular routine. And let's just, you know, most of the time people don't have, you know, they don't believe in resolutions. But this year I kind of do. I am fighting in every way that I can in my heart that I am going to strive and strive and strive to just be that man after God's own heart that I want to be. And that's my goal for 2017. That's my goal, and why don't you join me on that? If you're a man or a woman, just strive to be that woman or that man after God's own heart. And if you need prayer, leave it on the bottom of this video. I'll be praying for you. If you're gonna say, yeah, you know what, Ray, I'm gonna take that challenge and I'm gonna get my heart right with the Lord and get focused back on Him, you know what, leave me a comment that that's what you're gonna do, and I will pray for you that the Lord will just do something amazing in your life. So, until we meet again, God bless you all in the name of Yeshua. Thank you for watching this very long-winded explanation of what I'm doing in the next week. I love you guys all. Thank you for your comments. I read every one of them. I can't necessarily answer every one of them, but I do read every one of them. So, again, God bless you in the name of Yeshua. Until next time, bye for now.
So you thought you had to keep this up, all the work that you do. So we think that you're good and you can't believe it's not enough. All the walls you built up are just glass on the outside. So let them fall down. There's freedom waiting in the sound. When you let your walls fall to the ground, we're here now. This is where the healing begins. Oh, this is where the healing starts. When you come to where you're broken within, the light meets the dark. All your fear, so you hide, but you find.